this magnetic field, this activation of this magnetic field inspires growth and development. Trees, animals, lions, tigers, and bears operate up off of this electromagnetic solar radiation energy. They survive off the sun. The birds, everybody just living it up off the sun, providing us with solar radiation. All planetary energy, all from squirrels to rats to insects, owe their existence to the sun giving us solar radiation. Protons, neutrons, electrons. Protons, neutrons, electrons. Electrons are negative energies you can't see, can't touch, can't feel, but they represent what they have been charged with from a proton nuclear base. Quite simply, if you are a powerful king-like energy, then this is how you charge your electrons. The more you charge your electrons, the more you receive king, queen, goddess, god-like energy. And the same model, the same framework, is the same framework of our solar system. Our sun is a proton-neutron centrifugal force. The planets are electronic forces that operate within an orbit around our sun. Of these planets, and these rotations around this big star that is emitting off electromagnetic energy changes the Earth's magnetic field daily. This is why we study the transit charts to figure the ways for which the Earth's electromagnetic field will be altered. Thus, when Venus is conjunct Pluto, these energies affect the sun, the sun's electromagnetic energy, which this energy, because the sun receives energy and it also gives out energy, and it influences the energy that exists on our little Earth. And we know this because we also understand that in our fucking human bodies, it operates in the same way. It operates in the same way. Our heart, if your heart is right, your heart is related to your thoughts and your emotions. If your heart is right, you will get blessed in return. And the person standing right next to you, your homeboy, he getting his ass kicked because his heart ain't right. He ain't doing the right things. He think he ain't shit. So life is giving him that. You can't feel bad for him. You got to start to feel great for yourself. Everybody, I will boost a person up for a whole hour and a half during a reading, and they'd be like, well, this was great, but how am I going to help my mama? She going through something right now. I don't fucking know, fam. I'm talking to you, right? You got to help yourself, fam. Okay? And so when we look at our life and our energy, the sun is sending off this energy through its solar flares, creating solar winds, which actually is the energy that exists in our atmosphere. The solar wind is a stream of charged particles released from the upper atmosphere of the sun called the coronavirus. Its particles can escape the sun's gravity because their high energy resulting from the high temperature of the coronavirus, which in turn is a result of the coronal magnetic field. Meaning that when you are able to look at life from a correct point of view, you are able to access these charged particles, which even the concept of a person that is called a king comes from the fact that they are descended from the God of the heavens. Where is the God in the heavens from? Outer space. Thus, to be a divine son of somebody from outer space, which make you a king, is only somebody that has tuned in and tapped in to the star energy that exists outside of us. And we can all do that. It's just more or less of, we're not even explaining none of this type of stuff. So you have your sun energy for which you are giving, right? Then you have your moon energy, which is connected to the water. So the water is connected to the electric current. So you got the Hoover Dam, you got the Hoover Crips. No, I digress. You got the Niagara Falls. Now let's look at this. Water and its electrical current. Water is equated to electrical energy. The Niagara River flows over steep cliffs and two cataracts we call Niagara Falls. Starting over 100 years ago, power companies have used water in the Niagara River to generate electricity. So our concept of electrical energy is specifically taken from the flow of water. The flow of water generates electricity, almost to a point of a positive point where you can start to see the electrical current and harness that electrical energy and give it to other people and make money off of what the earth gives you naturally. But even deeper, when you begin to center yourself and when you begin to go to places like the Niagara Falls and go to rivers, you could absorb that electric energy that exists in the negative electron ionosphere level, and you can charge up your electrons. Your electrons get fed from the rivers, lakes, and streams. This is why our ancestors went to lakes, rivers, and streams to give offerings. Because at one level, what exists at the electron level is just as real as what exists at the proton level. It's just that we cannot see it with our physical eyes. You can't see a radio tower, but you can for sure turn to 106.5, today's hottest R&B and jams, and listen to T-Pain's latest hit song. So just because you can't see it, don't mean it ain't real, and don't mean that it can't affect you in a real way. We just have to be more mindful of these particular energies as melanated folk. So 100% of incoming solar radiation allows for plants to grow. It allows us to eat. The photosynthesis from the plant allows our body to grow and progress and adjust to the climate and the energy. The hydration for which in the plant and the fruit gets stored in our body. When we dehydrate it, it releases its hydration so we can stay healthy, we can stay happy. All solar activity on this world affects the magnetic field of this earth through solar wind, and this affects the tidal forces, creating electrical currents that exist everywhere you go. You walk around the world, every person you meet, it's an electrical current. When you scrub your feet up against some carpet and touch your little brother and you shock him, that's because all around us is electrical currents. Even deeper, no matter where you at, as long as some oxygen, you get a spark, get a couple of dry logs, and voila, you got fire. The fire is showing you that the fire exists with all around you, you just can't see it. Only when you add a spark to it, heat or fuel, you begin to see the oxygen and what the oxygen really looks like, and the oxygen really looks like fire. Thus, a fish does not know that they're in water, nor do human beings know that we walking around in goddamn the middle of a fucking firestorm. Because if fire didn't exist, then you would go to certain places and put some rocks and logs together and it wouldn't combust. But since it does combust, if there is no water, then that shows you that fire, oxygen exists all around you, just at different sites, electromagnetic spectrums. So this magnetic field, this activation of this magnetic field inspires growth and development, trees, animals, lions, tigers, and bears operate up off of this electromagnetic solar radiation energy. They survive off the sun, the birds, everybody just living it up off the sun, providing us with solar radiation. All planetary energy, all from squirrels to rats to insects, owe their existence to the sun giving us solar radiation. So let's talk about the sun.